Okay, I think I'm gonna start here. So, this is kind of in the middle of things. Very epic of it. Alright, so historic evidence, and not only from the distant past, is abundant in testifying that Roman Catholicism suppresses basic freedom whenever, wherever, and however she can. The claim of papal infidelity becomes the justification for such tyranny, a tyranny which Roman pontiffs have repeatedly expressed and enforced in Christ's name and as his alleged vicars. As von Dollinger himself, a devout Catholic, has pointed out, the whole life of such a man, the Pope, from the moment when he is placed on the altar to receive the first homage by the kissing of his feet, will be unbroken chain of adulation. Everything is expressly calculated for strengthening him in the belief that between himself and other mortals there is an impassable gulf. Did you hear that? So you're not the Pope, and you never could be the Pope. You need the Pope, and he doesn't need you, but he's your gateway. He's your gatekeeper to God, right? This is why the Catholic Church and all churches suck. Completely false. You know that guy that you talk to in your head when you have conscience? That's your God. You don't need to talk to this fucking Pope. Everything is especially calculated for strengthening him in the belief that between himself and other mortals there is an impassable gulf. And when involved in the cloud and fumes of the perpetual incense, the firmest character must yield at least to a temptation beyond human strength to resist. Pope Gregory the 16th, this is from 1831 to 1846, the triumph of the Holy See and the Church over the attacks of the invaders is one example among many. Its major thesis was that popes had to be infallible in order to fulfill the office of the true monarch. As absolute monarch over church and state, Gregory rejected freedom of conscience, not only within the church, but in society as a whole, as a false and absurd concept. Freedom of the press was equal madness. Did you catch that? This is the church now. Gregory's successor was Pius IX, convener of Vatican I. He was of the same mind with regard to the most elementary human freedoms. Popes had openly declared Rome's opposition to the United States and its freedom-granting constitution from the moment of the nation's birth. Did you hear that? We've been at war. You want to know why things are fucked up in this country while we're getting poisoned in our food? This is your answer right here. This is your answer. This is why the CIA runs children and steals them from you. This is all of this is because of this. I'll start again. The popes had openly declared Rome's opposition to the United States and its freedom-granting constitution from the moment of that nation's birth. Pius IX did the same. The Catholic world frankly expressed the Roman Catholic view of the U.S. from the U.S. form of government. We do not accept it or hold it to be any government at all. If the American people... I'm sorry. I'll start again. We do not accept it or hold it to be any government at all. If the American public is to be sustained and preserved, it must be by the rejection of the principle of the Reformation. So we're talking about, you know, not having to be subservient to the church. That's what the Reformation was. Fuck you! And the acceptance of the Catholic principle. A woman rides a beast. David Hunt. That's where that came from. So did you catch all that? Let's start all over again, because I think I just got it interrupted. We do not accept it or hold it to be of any government at all. We do not accept it or hold it to be any government at all. If the American Republic is to be sustained and preserved, that means, you know, sustained and preserved means not destroyed by the government, by the church. They're telling you that they're going to destroy us. If you want to be preserved and sustained, that means not attacked and destroyed. It must be the rejection of the principle of the Reformation and the acceptance of the Catholic principle. Good.